May 2019 will go down as one of the most active months for tornadoes in U.S. history. At one point, there were at least 8 tornadoes each day for 13 straight days, from May 17th to the 29th, a record since tornado record keeping began in 1950. And while states like Oklahoma, Kansas, Missouri, and Ohio saw some of the worst tornadoes, we did see tornadoes reported in Idaho and Oregon recently. This you see here is the tornado that touched down in eastern Oregon near the Steens Mountain Range. Thankfully, it did not do any damage. Tornado formation requires a strict set of ingredients, and the eastern U.S. is perfect for assembling these atmospheric requirements. The primary factors storms need is energy or instability, wind shear, that is the winds that turn and cause rotation, and moisture, lots of it. When these ingredients are in abundance, tornadoes and tornado outbreaks can occur. What we're missing in the Pacific Northwest is moisture. Thus, thunderstorms don't typically have enough juice and are not low enough to the ground to extend that rotation to form a tornado. Plus, the mountains can deflect and mess up the wind flow and low-level rotation or shear needed to sustain a tornado. So how do we see them on occasion? It's almost a fluke. Colliding wind flows in the right manner can prompt a thunderstorm to drop a tornado, but since the atmospheric dynamics aren't strong enough to support it, the tornadoes tend to be one-off moments and short-lived. Meteorologist Thomas Patrick, Crem 2 News.